Beloved, we've been focusing over the last several weeks on overcoming the powers of darkness. I began by talking about how demons enter, and we addressed the issues of being in agreement with sin and lies opens up the door for the powers of darkness to work and have access in our lives. Then we talked about generational spirits, how the same spirits that were on our parents or grandparents can operate in our lives because oftentimes they move down the line through the family tree. We talked about recognizing this so that we can separate ourselves from them because we become new creations in Christ Jesus, and He's given us victory over all the powers of darkness, regardless of what spirits have been in our family tree. Last week I talked about fear, and I just want to sum up today by sharing with you how important it is to cultivate peace in our lives. The world around us is filled with chaos. We're constantly being bombarded with all types of stimuli. If we're not careful, beloved ones, we're going to allow the world around us to rob us of the peace that we need to break the powers of darkness off our life. The Bible says, "Be still and know that I am God." Jesus, before choosing his apostles, went up on top of a mountain to be alone with the Lord by himself. In other words, someone that's going to have victory over demons and darkness needs to cultivate being alone with God, cultivating peace in their heart. We need to be very careful to pay attention to this principle. If we're not taking time every day to just spend alone with God, just sitting before Him, even when it feels like nothing happens, just believe that just by being alone before Him, God is strengthening your inner man in eternal life. Just continuing in this process, listen, it will strengthen your heart against the powers of darkness. I want to encourage you to understand we must have peace if we're going to break powers of evil off of our lives, which means that we need to be cultivating peace in our hearts. You see, the Bible tells us that soon the God of peace is going to crush Satan under our feet. Peace crushes the devil. This is why when Saul was tormented by a demon, David came and played the harp. And as David played the soothing music, we read that the demon left Saul. I want you to know, beloved ones, if you'll put Jesus first and be serious about pursuing peace, you're going to find yourself entering into more and more victory over the powers of darkness. This is Rabbi Schneider saying to you, God loves you, God bless you, and Shalom.